Tom Brown graduated from St. Andrews High School, where he was a four-year starter in baseball and was a member of the Class B runner-up team in 1954. The Bulldogs were the Saginaw Valley champions from 1952 to 54.
And he made himself a success. That was the thing that always impressed me, was nobody gave Tom anything. He worked to get what he got.
He played basketball 3 years, and the Bulldogs were crowned champions in both 53 and 54.
I remember one game playing basketball, high school basketball, and we had a young guy on our team who was, today he'd be known as a pure shooter. His name was Dick Drennan. And back in those days, that was like 53, 54. Didn't score a lot of points. But Tom pulled me to the side during the game and he said, let's start getting the ball to Dick and let him shoot. See how many points he can make. He made 50 points.
Brown would go on to Central Michigan College, where he was a four-year starter in baseball and lettered 2 years in basketball.
And I know that he played along Tom Tresh at Central Michigan. He was a great athlete in his own right, but he just had a knack because Tom is a numbers guy, always has been, taught math. And he could keep those things in his head, so that made him a good coach, but it also made him a very good administrator in regards to budgets and finance and those kinds of things, and that was his strength.
He was drafted by the Washington Senators in 1959.
He signed with them, when he graduated from Central and tried it that summer, but was home soon after. He didn't stay very long. And he went into coaching right away.
He wound up coaching at Bad Axe High School from 1959 to 62 as varsity basketball, assistant football, and varsity baseball coach. In 1962, he took over the basketball program at Northwood Institute until 1967, when he assumed the same role at Northwood's Indiana campus. He also served as athletic director. Brown also served as assistant football coach, head baseball coach, and golf coach at Northwood.
First, Tom was a great coach. He was a player's coach, but a disciplinarian, and we just had a great time playing for him.
He's really credited with building Northwood's athletic department. What a lot of people don't know, he was really on the forefront of building Northwood as a university.
As we all know, if you're going to be a vice president or a coach, there's a good chance that the vice president is going to make a little more money, and Tom did a great job and eventually rose to become the president of the university.
He helped found the Great Lakes Intercollegiate Athletic Conference in 1972 when he was an assistant to the president at Northwood. He later became president from 1979 to 82 before starting his own consulting firm in the Detroit area.
He was in the room when the conference was founded, when he was working for Northwood University. He understood it. And of course, athletics was always a passion of his, even when he was in administration at Northwood.
In 1992, he became commissioner of the GLIAC when Vern Norris retired. It was a position he held for 17 years. When he retired in 2009, it was the longest tenure of any commissioner and the first full-time commissioner in GLIAC history.
So I believe when this opportunity came along for him to come back in athletics when he was in his consulting business and be a commissioner, I think he jumped right at it, and he did it full bore.
During his turn at the helm, the conference expanded from 10 to 14 members and increased the sports sponsor to 20, 10 men's and 10 women's, including the reinstatement of football as a conference sport.
He had the forethought to put that together, to look at those colleges, to vet them out, and to find. We went into Pennsylvania.
The GLIAC moved from a Michigan-only conference to include members from Ohio, Pennsylvania, and Indiana.
The conference is very big and strong, and that's Tom's doing. But the big part of it is that the GLIAC has gone to be, without question, the strongest Division II conference in the country.
Even when I was coaching at Saginaw Valley in the 90s, we were 10-team All-Michigan League. He could see that that wasn't going to be sustainable, that we had to look outside. We looked inside, Michigan, but we found there was better and better candidates outside of the state.
In 2009, Brown was awarded an honorary Doctor of Laws degree by Northwood University.
Usually presidents come from a very academic background, and then I found out Tom's background as we worked together and we talked a lot about it and shared experiences. It was amazing to see all the different experiences he had, and it's one thing that really made him a remarkable administrator at that level, because he could relate to student athletes at the high school, collegiate, professional level. He could relate to coaches, having done that for a long time. He was an athletic director at Northwood. and then an administrator. So he knew every facet of, you know, what a college athletic department, how it worked, what it needed. And that gave him a remarkable perspective on the issues we had to deal with.
Since his retirement, he does consulting work for NAIA schools applying for membership in NCAA Division II.
But I want to make sure that he realizes what he has accomplished and how important it is to a lot of kids and families throughout the area.
The kids that went to Northwood and getting them through, getting them an education, having an impact on their lives, that's how you get these awards, is having an impact on other people's lives.
Congratulations, Tom. It's well deserved. I'm very proud of you, and I want to personally thank you for all the things that you've done for me and my family in my life. I've had a great life at Northwood and in Midland, and he brought me there. He is directly responsible for me being there, and I owe that to him, and it's just a gratitude of thanks.